special thing. Tonight is also the beginning of something even better. Tonight completes the final chapter in the book, over one decade in the making.
I can't have you sitting.
The main characters are a group of kids who along the way grew up. Some left and newcomers arrived. But a good portion have spent the last 13 years and my friends and my childhood buddies. Except they weren't playground pals anymore. All my friends were now men and women. Tonight is the end of that innocence we once enjoyed. Tonight we part company and head new directions. Tonight is the end, my beautiful friends. Tonight we grow up. What now? What happens tomorrow? Is it possible to become an adult? And one day by accepting your diploma? Where do we go? Well, I am not afraid of tomorrow, for I've seen yesterday and I love today. Some say that the moral state of the youth of America is in shambles, that our future looks pretty bleak. I'm not afraid. Within the hallways of Capitol High School, a group of kids have shown me enough compassion, intelligence, humor, and understanding to give me a great deal of confidence in our future. The members of the class of 1994 are genuinely good people. We care about tomorrow, show concern for each other, and believe in ourselves. We are not afraid of tomorrow. Now, sitting here tonight are over 423 graduates, each with 423 individual dreams and aspirations. We all have a good idea of who we are and what we want, and armed with the knowledge that dreams are more powerful than facts, hope always triumphs over experience, and laughter is the only cure for grief, we move onward. We are the dreamers, and we are the future. We complete our common goal of graduation. We have conquered the highest mountain we are yet to come upon. But as we gaze onward from this new vantage point, we see entire mountain ranges on the horizon. There will be many more mountains to climb. For tomorrow, we dream of becoming astronauts and actors, ball players and barbers, presidents and psychologists, and senators and school teachers. At this point in our life, a dream and a diploma is about all we have to go on. We are the future. Following our dreams will shape the world. The rock band Led Zeppelin wrote some lyrics, which I think epitomize the events occurring in our lives right now. Allow me to read them to you. As the eagle leaves the nest, it's got so far to grow. Changes fill my time, baby, that's all right with me. In the midst, I think of you, and how it used to be. So I said goodbye to all my friends, and packed my hopes inside a matchbox, because I know it's time to fly. The time has come, my friends, it is time to fly. Changes do fill our time. But I firmly believe that we have the ability to make those changes for the better. In order to make the world a better place, we will have to be better people. Tonight we leave our nest. Fly with honor, holding your head high. You guys have accomplished something truly remarkable, and I'm proud to call myself your classmate. I know it's time to fly. In the midst, think of us, now it used to be. We have shared many good moments upon the good ship Capitol, but all great things must come to an end. They say these are the best times of our lives, but I know that the best are yet to come. We have the potential, so do good things. Remember who you are and where you came from. Read a book, breathe the air, watch a sunset. Keep in touch. Use a firm handshake. Learn something new every day. Make new friends. Hold life in awe and celebrate if called for. Visit the zoo. Adapt and overcome. Keep your yearbook close at hand. Don't be a whiner. Follow your dreams. Go fishing. Ski for world peace. Read the comic strips, and be sure to remember these times. And when you do, laugh, and cry, and most importantly, smile. And above all else, take time out once in a while to just pause for a moment. Look to the mountains, a river, a tree, or any other wonder of nature. Breathe deeply, exhale, and sit back and realize the immensity and the beauty of it all. And say to yourself, it's good to be alive. Because, my friends, it is good to be alive. We have succeeded. Now this is our world to do with as we please. This is our place. Do well. Remember, I am not afraid of tomorrow, for I have seen yesterday, and I love today. It's good to be alive. Think of us and how it used to be. Goodbye to all my friends. I know it's time to fly. Ladies and gentlemen, your future. Thank you.
I'd like to call to your attention that the top 10% of the senior class and members of the National Honor Society are wearing black and gold honor cords this evening as a sign of their achievement. At this time, I have several groups of students that I would like to identify for very special recognition. As I identify each of these groups, audience, would you please hold your applause until we have read the names of the entire group. Would first of all like to introduce the senior class officers. President of the senior class, Anthony Litster. Stand, please. Vice President, Stuart Bowden. Treasurer, Stacy McCombs. Secretary, Heidi Peterson. Representatives, Jeremy Bronner and Michael Salee. These students represent the top 0.5% of students in Idaho who maintain the very highest of academic standards and have earned exceptionally high scores on the Scholastic Aptitude Test. I would like them to stand and be recognized, please. Terry Beck, Tyann Carter, Bob Lehman Jr. Would you give a hand to this program? The honor students are listed, and I would like these students to stand and remain standing. Again, please hold your applause until we have identified the entire group. First of all, those seniors with a 4.0 grade point average through seven semesters, Amy Baldwin, Terry Beck, Jeremy Bronner, Tyann Carter, Andrea Klein, Riley Cornett, Anna Flipcroft, Jennifer Gorman, Jamie Hamilton, Jill Hamilton, Holly Hessen, Janessa Hunter, Vicki Kinney, Paige Lovinger, Gabriel Matthews, Gavin McCaleb, Amy Sanders, Kimberly Storr, Shane Warden. Joining these students will be the students with a 3.75 to a 3.99 grade point average through seven semesters. Brandy Biesecker, Alicia Burkhart, Bridget Ciccarillo, Julie DeSarmo, Micah Dodson, Melissa Donahue, Jennifer Dunn, Misty Insminger, Benjamin Glover, Leah Gordon, Alicia Gregg, Lamia Hadzio Simonovich, Tracy Hall, Tanya Haas, Sandra Hatch, Kenneth Henningsen, Brandy Hostetler, Anna Korstad, John Cuny Jr., Bob Lehman Jr., Anthony Litster, Christina Mon, Stacy McCombs, Kimberly Metzger, Eric Mott, Roy Nelson, Natalie Olson, Don Ornelas, Heidi Purcell, make Capitol High a great school. They have inspired teachers with their positive attitude and the sheer force of their character and personality. Would these students stand, please? Noah Barr, Jamie Hamilton, Jill Hamilton, Sandra Hatch, Kelly Hussin, Gavin McCaleb, Leah Schroeder, Aaron Smith, Joel Weaver, Rachel Wood. Hand for these students, please. The top 10 seniors.
That they be awarded their diplomas. Dr. Homer, may I present the Capitol High School graduating class of 1994.
Thank you, Dr. Dennis, Mr. Arnold. You had two very, very fine young people speak to you this evening. To think of the terms, it's good to be alive, and I think the other term there, not afraid of tomorrow, I think all of this support group up here will feel better knowing that you are going to be part of our society and contributors of solving problems. Truly, this is a moment in time for you, and there will be partings, but not necessarily goodbyes. It'll just be parting until you meet again. Gavin quoted Shakespeare, and I'm going to quote William Jennings Bryan right now. Gavin mentioned destiny, and William Chandler Bryan said, destiny is not a matter of chance. It is a matter of choice. It is not a thing to be waited for. It is a thing to be achieved. It is our challenge to you to achieve your very best and to be contributors of our society. The Boise school system is a very, very fine system. You have gotten a good education, and you are indebted to Boise schools. We want you to come back and be contributors and helpers within the education of those that follow you. It gives me great pleasure at this time to begin the process of handing the diplomas out. Thank you.
As the graduates are coming, we remind you that to assure that every name is heard, as we recognize 13 years of hard work by our graduates, would you please hold your applause until graduates are recognized, and then we'll call for an applause for the entire 423 graduates.
Thank you. the face of Mom.
Date. Time.
Date and time. Notice the time? It is now 10:30. You should be in bed. You have to be up in 3.5 hours.
I have to. My chart is test.
Should we go home? Sandy's even going to the car. Let's hurry. Let's go.
What?
Don't show my pal!